Time to remove the clamps. Well, you know, something's bound to happen, right? I'm still thinking that I might have to do a little heat press on this thing now that I got it glued back together. But, we'll soon find out. Get rid of some of this stuff. Get rid of that. That should just peel off. Look at that. Come on out. A little bit of double-sided tape was holding my cleat together. Did I leave that on there? Put that floating around in there. No, it just stayed there, and it shall stay there. Well, that looks like a job for some Glue Boost Black to fill up that hole. Let's get this other one off of here. By far, the most usable clamp for doing this that I've ever used. So what we're hoping for is that when we come across there, so we're still out of whack. All is not lost. Come off this end. Let's just see something here for a minute.
Well, after a lot of gluing, screwing, tattooing, monkeying around, clamping, jigging, heating, this is really close. For the extra few dollars, I'm just going to put the Bridge Doctor in. It was suggested. I'm still not convinced there's enough room to get past the bracing here, but I'm going to look inside in a minute. We'll find out in a moment, won't we?
So you see those two braces that go across there? That could be interesting, but I'm just going to put my hand inside there and test fit that with the stick going across, because the stick has to clear those two things. Yeah, I've been down this road before. First I gotta put on my protective coating, because it's cold out already. So the way these things work is this goes up inside the guitar. I'm going to drill a hole through the bridge, and we're going to fasten this onto the back of the bridge. That goes underneath the saddle, and then by tensioning this rod with that screw that, uh-oh, don't lose that piece, you need that piece. By tensioning the rod with that screw that threads into this wood, which I am going to teach you what I learned the hard way with one of these before. Don't rely on that to really do much. You're going to want to push this down before you tighten that up inside. I'm just saying, if you're going to rely on that metal into the wood there to push this enough to make this move, I wouldn't suggest that. Okay, let's find drills.
They're going to tell you in the instructions.
Not to use a power drill. These are very special drill bits. And what I'm looking for, these are a brad tip. And that's not the one I want. Are you kidding me? The one I want is missing. I am going to go ballistic. Found it. Okay, so they say not to use power tools, but I am the power tool. So once I get this started, we're going to really go really slow with the drill bit motor. And this guy needs to only be about an eighth of an inch deep. Wish me luck. Now a little chamfer. You can do it, David. That's beautiful. Make sure you get this gadget in as straight as you can. And then you'll have to use a tool. Maybe I am the tool. So I don't want to bust this. That's the other thing. I get all excited and break. Okay. That's that bit of mess. The magical inside. That goes. Then we put the rod through and measure it and cut it. That can really screw you up too. Okay, before I cut this off to its optimum length, here's the deal. If I expect this gadget to get the belly out of this, that length is going to change. So what I've learned from the past is before I decide exactly where I'm cutting that, I'm going to put a clamp on this, push the belly out of it, cut this to length, put it in, and still with the clamp holding it, set this to where it's supposedly going to hold this someplace where it is now. It's probably going to be okay, but once string tension's on it, let me find the clamp. Survey says that is so utterly close. We ain't getting her better than that, but you could see, I'm going to put, see, I marked the stick. That's the tape where I put it on there where it was sticking out before. And I'm going to put the stick back in. It's going to be a different length. And that's something that happened to me another time. It was bad. Because when I got the belly out of it, the stick needed to be a different length. And where's my flashlight? Survey says stick needs to be a little longer, right? Okay, let me mark that again. Well, I've got this clamped, and then, like I said, once I cut the stick, I'm not taking these off. I'm going to set that post with that big set screw best I can with this helping. And then when I release these, it's going to go bang like a freaking coil spring. Survey says 1/32nd of an inch extra has to come off. Let's try that. If I screw it up, then I have to find a new stick. So now I will put the stick in the hole. And find that set screw. My best blind eye, go in there and put it in place.
Well, I'm quitting this kind for tonight. Mainly because I just want to let it sit. The other thing about cranking that thing inside there, it's not like an instant fix. I wouldn't like be cranking. I've learned that in the past. I've got it tight. I'm going to leave it overnight. Get strings tomorrow. Maybe turn that one or two more little turns. And the other thing that happens is if it starts to push too much and your rod gets a little short, you can drop a spacer in there, just a metal washer, to try and get it right. Because there's not a lot of thread on there. It's like, and it'll flex. Okay, so I'm quitting now. And all the great links, the cool stuff, is in the description below. become a patron. Big shout out to my patrons. Subscribe, that's easy. You can give a like. You can get a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker. You could get one of the infamous Penny Black CDs with all the amazing musical interludes on that. And most of all, be safe, be good to each other. Cheers.